If you are under the sound of my voice, just know your light has come and your life will never be the same. Without wasting much of our time, let us lead the word for today. We are going to read 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 5. This is how the holy women of old made themselves beautiful. They trusted God and accepted the authority of their husbands. Our text today is the beauty of the woman. We see in our text the Bible is teaching us that the women of old made themselves beautiful. How did they made themselves beautiful? The Bible says, one, they trusted God and accepted the authority of their husbands. Let us look at the first point here. They trusted God, meaning that their trust wasn't in their husbands, but their trust was in God, meaning that they spent more time with God. They spent more time listening with God and not listening with a human being. In marriage, as a husband has laws, and the wife as well has a law to play. And in this Bible, we see the law of a woman. What is the law of a woman? If a woman is doing that particular law, we'll see that marriages will be going on fine. If two in a marriage are moving in their laws, are doing their laws, there will be harmony in marriages. Things will be working well in marriages. Things are not going on well in so many marriages because we have diverted from our laws, from our biblically given laws. In our today's message, we are going to deal with the law of a woman in a marriage. What is the law of a woman for a marriage to be as beautiful? Our text is the beauty of a woman, and then the beauty of a woman is seen by doing her own law in a marriage. What is the law of a woman in a marriage? The Bible is telling us that they first trusted God and then they submitted themselves to their husband, meaning that they accepted the authority of their husband. To accept the authority of your husband, that means you have submitted. The moment a woman says, "I love you," a man describes that kind of a love in 3 ways. Number one, he looks at submission. Does this woman submit to me? Number two, he looks at honor. Does this woman honor me? And number three, he looks at respect. Does this woman respect me? The love of a wife to a husband is not good cooking, is not taking warm water and live in a bathroom for your husband. It's not cooking well. Yes, it is good to cook well. It is good to dress well and look beautiful. It is good to take care of a husband in terms of cooking well, in terms of preparing bathing water, making that water to be warm. Those things are good. But mainly, the husband doesn't look at those things. When a wife says, "I love my husband," the husband looks at that love in 3 dimensions. He first analyzes the submission. Does this woman submit to me? And then he analyzes honor. Does this woman honor me? And then he analyzes respect. Does this woman respect me? So the law of a woman in a marriage is in 3 ways. Has to submit to a husband, has to honor her husband, and has to respect her husband. The moment you see problems happening inside a house, the moment you see problems coming in a marriage, first you have to analyze these things. Am I doing my law correctly? Am I submitting to my husband? Am I honoring to my husband? Am I respecting my husband? When these things are intact, then all is well if there are some problems, that means you have to look in the other dimension. That's why the Bible says the women of old trusted their God. The moment you see that you are doing everything and then you see there's a problem in a marriage, then you must trust God more. To trust God more is to speak more to God himself and not your husband, is to spend more of your time with God in prayer, 15 minutes to 2 hours. Don't just be talking, don't just be speaking, but you must be with the Lord in prayer, asking him, what is wrong with my marriage? What am I supposed to do? What is happening? If there are some attacks, what do I need to do? That means you have to wage war against the attacks from the camp of an enemy. What does it mean to submit? To submit is to give up. That means you say, I come to you, I'll do what you tell me to do. There are some things as a woman you might have been doing when you were with your parents. You might have been walking into when you were with your parents. For example, the dressing. There is a certain dressing you used to dress when you were with your parents. But when you come to your husband, it is that moment you say, here I am. I am going to put on the clothes you want me to put on. If you don't want me to be putting on these things, that means I'll have to stop it. That's what we call submission. I used to come home this time, but if you say I must be home by this time, I'll submit, I'll start doing it. That's what we call submitting. Submitting is to give up your desires, is to give up what you usually do just to suit what someone wants you to be doing. That's what we call submitting. It's like giving up. It's like, I'll do everything you say I must do. As a wife, you must do everything that your husband tells you you must do, except if it is a sin. If it is a sin, then you must not do it. Why? The Bible asked the husband to be the head of a family, as Jesus is the head of the husband. So every husband must be under the authority of Jesus. So to be under the authority of Jesus means not to tolerate any sin. So if you are not to tolerate any sin, that means you are not going to allow someone to do any sin by submitting unto you. So everything that your husband asks you to do, if it is not a sin, then just do it. That's what we mean by submitting. Submitting is something difficult, is something that makes you to be small. And many people really would not like to submit. But the Bible says, if you want your marriage to work well, you just have to submit. You must do that which your husband wants you to do, that which your husband wants you to be dressing, that which your husband wants you to be doing. Sometimes it can be even a church. When you were with your parents, you used to go to a certain church. But when your husband says, we'll now start going to this church, that means you have to submit. That means you have to do that which your husband asks you, you must do, provided it is not a sin. Each time your husband asks you to do something, ask yourself, is it a sin? If it is not a sin, then you must do it. The moment you rebel, the moment you do not do that which he asks you to do, that's the moment you start bringing problems in your marriage. That's the moment you start bringing conflicts in your marriage. Some marriages today are not going on well just because children are receiving directives from their parents. Parents are leading marriages of their children. Why there are many problems in the marriages today? It is not good. What is honor? To understand honor, we are also going to put it in three ways. When a woman says, I love my husband, it means I honor my husband. What is honor? Honor, the first step of honor is to recognize that which your husband represents. If you recognize that which your husband represent, if you understand that which your husband represent, you must then celebrate it. And then after you have celebrated it, you must be able to reward it. That's what we call honor. What are we talking about? Your husband is not just a business person. He is not just a nurse. He's not just a policeman. He is not just what kind of a job he is doing. But your husband is also what God created him to do. There's a particular work that God instructed your husband to do. And if you recognize that work and then you celebrate it and reward it, the better for you. That's what we call honor. Remember, when we read Genesis chapter 2 verse 18, the Bible says a woman is there to be like a helpmeet to a husband. A helpmeet for what? When we read verse 15, the Bible says man was placed in a garden to take care of it, which means the work of a man is being in a garden, to take care of a garden. And every creation, every man has his own garden. So to honor your husband is to recognize his own garden. What is his own garden? What is the garden God has placed him to do? If you recognize that which your husband has been called to do, that which your husband has been assigned divinely to do, if you recognize it, the Bible says you must celebrate it. The first step is to recognize. If you recognize it, that's what we call honor. Many wives today do not recognize that which their husbands have been divinely assigned to. If you do not recognize that which your husband has been divinely assigned to, you will fail to honor him. You can only honor your husband if you recognize that which he represents in a society, that which he represents in a community, that which he represents in a world at large as his earthly assignment divinely. What was your husband assigned to do? Do you recognize it? And after you have recognized it, do you celebrate it? Do you reward it? You have to celebrate it and you have to reward it. That's what we call honor. And that's what we call love. You love your husband if you are able to submit and if you are able to honor him. You are honoring him if you are recognizing what he represents. To recognize what he represents and to celebrate it is to make sure you do that which you are invited to do. Many marriages today are being destroyed because of dishonor, are being destroyed because of lack of submission. If as a wife you say you love your husband, that shall mean submitting to him and honoring him. And lastly, it is respect. Do you respect your husband? For you to know that you are respecting your husband, I just want you just to compare what you do to him and that which you do to your own father at home. How do you treat your father at home? Usually, we ladies or we women who respect our own fathers. And in the same way you respect your own father, you must respect your own husband. Just put images in yourself. How do you treat your father at home when it is lunchtime? How do you treat your father when it is supper? How do you treat him? How do you prepare his food? How do you put the food on the table? And how do you do it with your husband? You need to respect your husband as if is your own father. Your husband is like your master. Your husband is like your own father, and you have to respect him the same way you would respect your own father. Remember, when a woman says, "I love my husband," it is not just a good preparation of food. It is not just being dressed well. It is not just cooking well or preparing warm water for the husband to take a bath. is not just that. It means submission. Your love for a husband means submission. Your love for a husband means honor. And your love for a husband means respect. You are submitting if you are doing everything your husband asks you to do. That is what we call submission. If it is not sin, whatever your husband asks you to do, you must do it. And honor means recognizing what your husband represents. You must recognize that which he represents, you must celebrate it, and you must reward it. That's what we call honor. And then when it comes to respect, you must respect him just as you respect your own father. Before you do anything to your husband, ask yourself, will I do this thing to my own father? Why? Your husband is your own father. Your husband is your master. You have to follow biblical principles in loving your husband. If you want no problems in your marriage, then you must follow your laws according to the Bible. Understand your law as a woman. It is to submit, it is to honor and respect your husband. If you do these things, I tell you, you'll see your marriage being so beautiful, things working on well. God bless you, and may this light you have carried in this teaching be upon your life. May you shine like never before. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.